This is a true story. True story.
Seven strangers picked to live in a loft
and have the lodge peep
to find out what happened.
What?
When people stop being polite.
Could you get the phone?
And start getting real.
The real world.
Wednesdays at 1800s. Here.
Verdient hätte er 2 Jahre im Knast. Stattdessen bekommt er einen Sitz im Parlament.
Gebt mich euch noch mein Ehrenwort!
Doch ist er nicht der einzige Betrüger. Er ist der
Kinder,
Beste.
Kinder, ich sage euch aus Erfahrung, das ist nicht fair.
Ihnen kann ich auch was beinpicken, und zwar so. Schön, ne?
So, jetzt geht's!
Erleben Sie Eddie Murphy in Ein ehrenwerter Gentleman. Jetzt neu im Kino.
Can soap keep your skin feeling young all over?
Of course not. Washing means soap, and soap can mean dryness.
We asked Tessa to stop using their usual soap and try new conditioning bath bar from Oil of Ulay. The only bath bar made with Oil of Ulay moisturizes. It helps lock in skin's precious natural moisture while you wash.
My skin felt smoother, just as clean as the soap, but not a bit dry. Much, much softer. I feel so young.
What's more, there's new Ulay 2-in-1 shower and lotion. It combines a mild shower gel with a unique Ulay body lotion. New Ulay conditioning bath bar and 2-in-1 shower and lotion for young feeling skin all over.
I'll never let soap near my skin again.
Hier spricht Booker. Pro7 präsentiert meine Hits 93 mit Dr. Alban. Und wenn ihr sie nicht kauft, dann muss ich das leider gegen euch verwenden. Booker Hits 93, das Album zu meiner Show. Auf CD und MC war auch längst überfällig.
Machen Sie es möglich. Rufen Sie 001-809-563-0000. Sprechen Sie mit interessanten Leuten landesweit. 001-809-563-0000. Treffen Sie neue Leute 24 Stunden am Tag. 001-809-563-0000. 001-809-563-0000.
The weight of the world is love. Under the burden of solitude, under the burden of dissatisfaction, the weight we carry is love. The warm bodies shine together in the darkness. The hand moves to the center of the flesh. The skin trembles in heavy. And the soul comes joyful to the eye. That's what I wanted.
I always wanted.
I always wanted to return.
To the body where I was born.
Jetzt den Freundin.
If you can't wait to get rid of your dandruff, don't worry.
New Head & Shoulders now sifts dandruff 25% faster.
It's already won 3 Golden Globe Awards.
Ooh, mama.
Now, Scent of a Woman has been nominated for 4 Academy Awards. Best Picture, Best Director, Best Actor, and Best Screenplay. In the tradition of Dead Poets Society and Rain Man comes a must-see movie. Witty, tragically funny, Al Pacino at his best. Al Pacino, Sense of a Woman.
What's the number one record of the week? What is Ray Koch's favorite food? Find out on MTV Pex. What great MTV competition can I win? Where does Rebecca like to boogie in Berlin? Find out on MTV Pex. Where is my favorite band playing next week? What's on MTV tonight? Find out on MTV Pex.
Remember, don't know what you don't know, only know what you know.
Okay, fine. What do you mean?
Bye.
Hey, how you doing?
Hello? This is Ed. Jimmy, Matthew.
Hello, Ed. Good evening, Ed.
Okay.
Hello, Ed.
Hello?
How are you, Ed?
No, it's Jimmy.
What, Jimmy?
Jimmy.
Yeah. I thought your name was Ed.
No. This is Ed. Matthew.
Hello, good evening, Ed. And good
Ed.
Talk.
No, it's Jimmy.
So, Jimmy, have you seen our video link?
Who's the plane that one there? Anders, no, who's the plane that one? That one there, yeah.
Look around.
Can you hear me, can't they?
Yes. It's a mad hat to pub, a good pub, Jimmy.
What?
It's a mad hat to pub, a good pub.
Yeah, what you fucking do?
What you say what I said, Jimmy? Excellent, Jimmy. Yes, thank you.
Did you hear us from Jimmy?
Yes. Have you got any more swearing people we can use?
Sorry?
Have you got any more swearing people we can use?
Yeah, we've got loads more people. Do you want to talk to some more lively paddy people?
Okay, me. You're going in and out of the pubs in Dublin in the name of Most Wanted.
I've got a lovely lady here dressed in green, and she's going to tell you all about what's been happening today, Ray. You ready? Her name is...
Okay, now start putting her on. Hello?
Hello, the parade was brilliant. There was loads of people there.
The parade
loads
was brilliant.
Loads of kids drinking and everything.
Excellent, lads. The parade was brilliant.
And dancing, and we're all going to go mad in the madhouses tonight.
Excellent, mad in the madhouses tonight.
And this place is nightclub.
Right, okay, stood up now.
Did you get that, Ray?
No, I didn't. What was it?
We've got Bamsey, the owner.
Oh, what the owner
is
saying now? Right, okay, you take care of him. Yes, you're right here. Right, okay, right, let's have something else in the train.
Can we have a few girls on the counter here, please, quick? The first girl is on the counter with her green panties off. Get the
fight. Oh, that was a joke, Ray.
Right, thank you, Niamh. Excellent choice of people on the train, Niamh.
We'll see you later.
We'll join you later with some more lively folks.
Oh, they're very lively. By the way, Ray, just before you go, did you know that everybody's wearing white knee socks here today?
Are they?
Yeah.
Why is that, Niamh?
White knee socks backwards, even.
Why?
Why? Can you hear me?
Yes.
It's just an old tradition that everybody ignores, but the real Irish people pay attention to it, wearing white knee socks backwards and eating fluffy mashed potatoes.
Well, there you go. Another strange European tradition.
Will you say hello to Rob and Andy? I met them in London a week ago, and they promised me they'd wear green knee socks.
You say hello to them just for a second, Niamh. I'm just going to go and beat up Alan the Dictator. Right, Alan. Bloody idea, mate. I mean,
How are you doing?
Right, okay, thanks, Niamh.
All right, bye-bye.
Right, thanks, Niamh. We'll see you later with another
club. Talk to you later. Bye.
Bye to the Mad Hatter in Dublin. Good idea, Alan. Yeah, she'll go far on television with Alan Dictator. Right, here's for everyone watching in the Mad Hatter in Dublin. This is the House of Pain, and we'll see you later with some more painful but true television. Just some more time with you.
Okay.
MTV, on to the next thing. We'll be back after this break with music from the frames and some more call out to Dublin. Join us then.
Mondays at midnight. Switch on to MTV's Rock Block. 2 hours of your favorite rock music. Rock Rock Block, Monday at midnight on MTV. Rock, not metal.
The name's MC Mello.
A little bit of sweaty, damn it. You don't like it, you can pick up the word of sweaty. Hey, 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 rock,
rock, rock. Rock music, rock music.
Damn it, damn it, damn it, damn it.
United Sports.
Wieder mal gelangweilt? Interessiert an einem neuen Weg, Leute kennenzulernen? Nimm einfach den Hörer ab und ruf an. 001-809-563-4x0. Eine super Fete wartet auf dich, die Party 9. Unterhalte dich mit tollen Leuten aus ganz Europa 24 Stunden am Tag. Worauf wartest du noch? 001-809-563-4x0. 001-809-563-4x0.
Good as the ball didn't get there exactly when it got there, there would either have been, an interception or a knockdown. Amazing. 14-0.
Moscorn Enterprise rent a car. So our car is sick.
Enterprise will arrange to pick you up.
Wow!
Drive you to our place and get you on your way.
Everybody loves to be picked up.
Pick Enterprise. We'll pick you up.
In a perfect world, your cooking would taste more like your mom's.
Woohoo!
In the real world, Diet Dr. Pepper does taste more like regular Dr. Pepper. It's the taste you've been looking for.
Every so often, something new comes along that makes people go back to rethink. Go back to reconsider. Go back to the drawing board. Introducing the larger, more powerful Accord. An Accord like no other. From Honda.
Holiday greetings from Budweiser. From our family to yours, we wish you a very safe and happy holiday season.
Nice pants.
There's a nice boy.
Darkers, khakis.
We come here on a glorious quest. A search for that which can be found nowhere else. Where, in the trenches where mighty men clash, amidst the echoes of glory's past, high atop Olympus. Oh, this is our quest. This is what football is all about. Now all I gotta do is play that nacho guy.
Outstanding timepieces are built to run forever without replacing batteries, but only one of these is smart enough to run forever. On any kind of light, Echo Drive from Citizen. Live at the speed of light.
Disney's Flubber is bounced into McDonald's and theaters. And now you can waltz away with a tempting triple cheeseburger for just 99 cents. Or a 99 cent egg McMuffin for breakfast. Now that ought to get you moving.
Go Flubber. Go Flubber.
Sorry.
For work? Try the new Accord V6 Coupe from Honda. What
What's the secret behind Agent Scully's daughter?
Why didn't you tell me, Mulder?
I thought I was protecting you.
An all-new X-Files, tonight at 9, 8 Central.
Wendy's, where you can taste the difference fresh makes, presents plays that make a difference. In week 13, the Seahawks were soaring, but stay tuned to see how the Chiefs pulled off the comeback victory.
Happy holidays, Dave.
Same to you, Red.
I think you'll find this spicy chicken sandwich spicier than yours.
Not bad. But remember this?
Wendy's spicy chicken is seasoned with Dave's own blend of pepper and spices for that spicy hit you crave.
So?
So you got any more in the bag?
Maybe.
Yeah. All right.
Wendy's spicy chicken sandwich. It can warm up anybody.
Hey, jingle bell, jingle.
Trailing by 3 points, the Chiefs used a bootleg to bury the Seahawks.
If he wants to. Touchdown, Kansas City!
A nifty call and the crucial moment in the Chiefs' divisional victory.
Before you ask a woman out, always remember one thing.
Your slides.
Ally McBeal, an all new episode Monday after Melrose Place.
People worldwide.
We're back at Ericsson Stadium where we're down in the final seconds of the game and it's still tied. The kick's high. And
Ericsson mobile phones. Catch the excitement.
I heard my door close and I ran out to the truck and this guy is standing there with a case of beer in his hand and he tells me, he goes, oh, I was putting it back.
My days are usually 10 to 12 hours a day. Come in here, get my invoices. From there, I get out on the road, start delivering.
You see people, you go into the bars and you see people drinking and you think, that looks good. I wish I could have one right now, especially on a hot day like today.
It's a tough job, but I love it.
I've been equipment manager for the New York Jets for over 34 years. I've suited up more than 3,000 players. As long as I've worked this long, it's crazy to retire. The Jets are like my family. They're like my own kids.
Bucks go to the Jets next week, trying to get into the playoffs. The Pack are in. We go inside the numbers in case you're not convinced yet. Check this out. Since that wake-up call loss to the Colts, last three games against Dallas, Minnesota, and Tampa Bay, 34 points allowed, barely more than 200 yards a game allowed. The Pack is back. When we continue, Rams Saints, entertaining. Tony Banks and Isaac Bruce, the Reverend, hook up. Neil O'Donnell, not that entertaining for the Jets at home against the Colts. Vikings and Niners, what a week it's been in San Francisco. When they get on the field, do they end all their troubles?
An accident can be a traumatic experience, but at Golden State Auto Body and Paint, we're here to help. When you bring your car to Golden State, we end the hassles because our friendly staff handles them for you. From arranging for a rental car to negotiating with the insurance company to giving your car the highest quality repair possible so it's safe to drive again, we understand what you're going through. And we turn an unpleasant experience around to give you peace of mind. Bring your car to Golden State Auto Body and Paint. We're your neighbors and your friends.
The mall without a hobby, la 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 la. All the dealers are feeling jolly, la 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 la.
The annual year-end sale.
sale begins now at the Roseville Auto Mall. With the biggest discounts and best financing on our largest inventory of the year. With more number one dealers, 22 makes, and 5,000 vehicles in stock, the Roseville Auto Mall is the perfect place to make your holiday dreams come true. At the
Roseville Auto Mall. Does take its toll. For Kenny Mayne, I'm Dan Patrick. Good night. Once we finish a show, we do it all over again for the overseas markets.
Buenas noches, amigos. Me llamo Kenny Mayne.
Same highlights, same anchors, different dialects.
Dos vidania. Menu zabut, Boris Patrick.
Vut, Kenny Mayneski.
To touch people all over the world, that's special.
Welcome back to NFL Primetime. Falcons, Chargers. Wait, come on. Don't laugh. I mean, I said don't laugh. How about the Falcons on a 3-game roll? How about a 4-1
Her friend sip Chablis and Sherry after dinner. His guzzled beer before, after, and for dinner. The check, please. The opposite sex and how to live with them. Next.
Every Friday at 8 p.m., the curtain's going up on something new. Cinemax premiere. Take a look at what's coming soon.
She was house sitting. He was house breaking.
Who are you?
First, it was a game of cat and mouse.
Ooh. Come on. Where are we going?
To bed. Now they're playing house until some unexpected guests arrive.
I'll pay you $10,000 if you let me kill her.
Michael Madsen and Helen Slater share A House in the Hills. Coming in May on Cinemax.
Every Wednesday at 8 p.m., revolutionary, visionary, Cinemax Vanguard. Take a look at what's on this week. Sure, you see the high-minded, low-budget motion picture miracle that proves you don't need big bucks to make it happen on the big screen. El Mariachi, Wednesday Vanguard at 8, April 27th.
What makes Cinemax the best movie network on TV? Here's a reason you might not know. We've got a different kind of movie every weeknight at 8. Everything from comedy to drama to suspense. The movies change every Monday through Friday, but the time to tune in is always the same. So if you like movies, you've got the picture. Ah! A different kind of movie every weeknight at 8. That's a week's worth of reasons why Cinemax is the best movie network on TV.
Hi, this is Max. You know, I've always wondered how movies go from the set to Cinemax. I just had to find out. So I packed up my skis and went to America's largest film market, Robert Redford's Sundance Film Festival.
This festival is a festival for the filmmakers, and that was our purpose when we started in 1985, and it's still our purpose.
Every year, Robert Redford, the guru of independent filmmakers, brings together the adventurous souls crazy enough to use their own money to make a movie.
People are here with films they made for $7,000, you know, they still have their grandmother's insurance money or something and went and made a movie. You know, that's independent filmmaking. I like that.
Filmmakers from all over the world come to Sundance, dress in their best flannel, ski, and try to sell their films to major studios or to Cinemax.
It's got a lot of really earnest filmmakers that have made a lot of low-budget films and feel kind of morally superior to the studio system.
In the past, films like The Water Dance, Johnny Suede, In the Soup, and Paris is Burning have all been discovered at Sundance. Now, studio executives and distributors make an annual pilgrimage to the festival in search of this year's sleeper hit.
It's really a place for filmmakers to reach, I guess, people in the film industry and in the film community generally.
Everybody loves to see stars, and they're out in force at Sundance. Their job is to look great, do interviews, and promote.
This is here to promote Siren.
I'm in a few low-budget films that are in the festival.
To promote Reason.
Well, the film that opened it was called Four Weddings and a Funeral, and I'm in that.
Most importantly, everyone's watching how the local crowd reacts to the film.
I'm a little nervous, actually, because, you know, it's a film festival situation where everybody just talks about movies.
After all, It's the public who ultimately decides if a film's a hit.
A lot of great films are shown here, and documentaries, and I think it's a wonderful way to learn about what's happening in the business.
Now, not all the films shown here are looking for a buyer. Some films use this Hollywood and snow atmosphere to make their world premiere. This year, the Coen brothers came to Sundance with their new film, Hudsucker Proxy, starring Paul Newman, Tim Robbins, and Jennifer Jason Leigh.
We came here with our first movie, Blood Simple, when nobody knew very much about the movie or knew very much about
It's a pretty impressive sight, especially when you add all the other Hollywood people who come to Sundance just to schmooze and make the scene.
Gotta have popcorn for a great movie. Reality Bites.
Some of the films shown this year at Sundance may already be in theaters, and all the others...
We're looking for a distribution deal. All the major distributors come here. We're hoping to leave with a deal.
The big find this year for Cinemax was Colorado Cowboy, the Bruce Ford story.
Ty Murray, the person I consider the greatest cowboy that ever walked the face of the earth. This is the greatest film about the greatest bareback rider he ever seen, and that was two pats on the back right there.
But getting the big deal with Sundance isn't the most important thing.
Just getting picked here is like getting an Academy Award nomination for an independent filmmaker.
I just loved all the films at Sundance because they're a little quirky and offbeat, just right for Cinemax.
Guess what's coming this summer? It's a tidal wave of movies. There's Redford and Douglas and Griffith and Mel. There's A Big Fish, A Dead Guy, A Bratty Kid, and a lot more. There's a groundhog, a president, a preacher, and some pretty scary moments. There's people getting lost, people getting found, people falling in love, and lots of people fighting. It's a marathon of movies. The Cinemax summer of more than 1,000 movies. Coming this summer to the best network for movies on TV.
He really wants to get in your bed. My pants are taken.
My father said that if you stay in one place long enough, then your luck knows where to find you.
You've just been stuck in this town. You don't know.
I know that two people can meet each other and it's like they've never been alone.
Kate, Fonda, Roth, and Stolt. Bodies Rest in Motion. Thursday on Cinemax.
He knew she was too young.
She's got a crush on you.
Don't be silly.
He could see she was sexy.
Give it to a virgin.
What? But he didn't realize she was so dangerous.
I love you, Nick, and you love me.
You're sick.
Until it was too late.
Rape a little girl, you act like she's crazy?
Are you crazy?
I still love you, Nick.
The Crush. Premieres Friday at 8 on Cinemax. Dating in the 90s.
We were scoping and scamming just like everybody else.
It's a jungle.
I just don't think we should rush into anything.
Don't let your emotions get the better of you here.
And getting what you want.
I'm in love with this woman.
At last, a real man.
Could be worse than not getting it at all.
What's wrong?
I feel trapped.
And yet their relationship survived.
The opposite sex and how to live with them. Next on Cinemax.
Sunshine for the time being and a chance of showers, no kidding, moving in toward the latter part of the week. Currently, downtown Sacramento under clear skies, we have a temperature of 54 degrees.
Protective fence around you.
You guys are so bad.
No, we're not.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Shelley.
I'll let you know when I hatch.
The baseball season is officially underway, and Eric has highlights for you.
And Joe Montana finds a new way to spend some time.
257-day layoff, the baseball season began with booze and a big crowd. I didn't say booze.
No, that was a Z.
I meant booze. Who said the strike kept those fans away from the ballpark? Over 42,000 showed up tonight in Miami for the opener between the Marlins and the Dodgers. Apparently, one of the Kellys finds that very funny. Let's take you to the ballpark. And they'll conclude the season on the 24th. That is Christmas Day, I believe.
Eve,
thank you, against the Atlanta Falcons. Good thing I got Kelly here with me. Meanwhile, Joe Montana hasn't wasted any time finding a way to spend his retirement. 1 week after saying goodbye to football, Montana announced today that he has become a partner in a racing team, yes? Joe Montana and Indy Cars, as he told everyone today that he's just looking forward to getting to know everybody on the racing circuit. Locally, the Sacramento Kings said thanks to their season ticket holders today at Paradise Island. And several of the Kings enjoyed a few putting lessons from the many fans out there tonight. Mitch Richmond, Walt Williams, Dwayne Coswell, Lionel Simmons, and Spud Webb trying to figure out how to line this putt up. I guess he got it in the hole there. I don't know. Let's see. There he is.
I just figured out why my Christmas gift was late for me last year.
Why is that, Billy?
Stay with us. We'll be right back.
Known to get snow at Blue Canyon this late in the season.
We're all threatening another Blue Canyon.
Yeah, exactly. Won't be that big a deal, though.
Thank God.
Yeah, exactly.
And guess what else is back?
Yeah.
Baseball.
Baseball
at long last. Yeah. Tonight's Major League opener is any indication. The hitters are a step or two ahead of the pitchers as we begin the 95 campaign.
Nothing. Do you think the referee should stop this fight because he's not fighting back?
I'm in this man's corner. I won't voice no opinion on that, but although you see this man, he's still there. All he's got to do is fight.
Thank you, George.
Well, Oliver McCall's been talking religion this week, saying that he has found God in his life. That's his new mechanism for attempting to deal with all the problems that have haunted him in the past. Tuesday, he told a group of boxing writers, I'm going to retire after this fight. It's not godly to train for a long period of time to go out and try to hurt another man. Then Wednesday, at a pre-fight news conference, he said, no, I'm not going to retire. I will keep fighting after I win the championship. But something interferes with Oliver McCall's motivation. Round four closes here.
Jim, I think this fight should be stopped right now.
Yeah, the fight shouldn't go on. I wouldn't want to see
it. I mean, this is
like
a farce. What is the old saying? The first time is tragedy. The second time is farce. There's something wrong with Oliver McCall. He's near tears now. He doesn't really want to fight. He's crying in his corner. I've never seen anything like this. He's overwhelmed with some sort of emotion.
Don't do this to yourself. Don't do this to yourself, man. Come on, take the water.
He doesn't want to fight.
Come on, sit down, man.
Oliver, sit down. Now, you want to fight? Huh? You don't want to fight?
Yeah, you want to fight. Come on.
You heard Mills Lane say, do you want to fight? Reluctantly, it seems, he said yes, but it doesn't show on his face.
McCall's share of tonight's purse amounts to close to $3 million.
If I was in the commission here, I would hold that purse up. This is a disgrace. It's almost like you're watching a man come apart at the seams.
Well, in a life filled with crises, Oliver McCall is having one right now before the eyes of the world, and it's placed Lennox Lewis in an awfully difficult and awkward position. Lewis doing what he has to do.
This isn't right.
You wonder how much longer Mills Lane will allow this to go on. And that's going to be it.
Well, I've seen some strange things in boxing. That is surely one of the strangest.
With a whimper, not a bang, Lennox Lewis has just become the WBC World Heavyweight Champion for the second time in his career. Mark Ratner, Executive Director of the Nevada State Athletic Commission, joins us now at ringside. Mark, your take on what you just saw.
We are going to hold up his purse. We are not going to let him cash his letter of credit. We're very upset with what happened. We'll have a full investigation. He will not get paid tonight.
It did not appear as though he wanted to fight.
That is correct. We're very upset.
Thank you very much, Mark. So now Larry Merchant goes into the ring, and George, that was painful.
Yeah, but this guy's had a painful life for the last few moments. He's been under counseling for drugs, and believe me, there's a lot of young people in that six, in the same six he's in. Someone's going to have to help him.
The last thing he needs in his life is the pressure of boxing right now.
Yeah, there's a lot of pressure, and the crowd is cheering, and I wanted to just get up there and embrace him and let him know it's going to be okay. It's going to be okay, because where do you go from here?
Let's hope he can continue to pursue the path of religion in which he now believes, and that can be the reconstructive mechanism in his life.
Yeah, believe me, there are a group of people in this country who's in the same shape he is, and they really need us. And this guy is in bad shape, and he needs us. And I don't know, I'm sorry to see the boxing crowd see something like that, because maybe they're unfamiliar with it, but we see this every day in the lives of young people who got mixed up, got on the wrong side of the track, and they can't get back on.
George, you're a devout Christian. You're believing.